were saying, that's a German word, I know what that means. And there are a lot of definitions that kind of fit in with exactly what Gesellschaft and Gemeinschaft are. Gesellschaft can be company, it can be society, it can also mean a group of people together. Well, what about, I've lost my slide there, Gemeinschaft? It can mean mutual, it can be together, but it can also mean community. So tonight I want to talk about these two things for a few minutes, and a little bit of the pathway of how or why there is an art to them. So our friends here are the two people who kind of put the language of Gemeinschaft and Gesellschaft into the canon of sociology. These are the ones who define the importance of these two ideas. Ferdinand Hoeneß was writing in 1887. He was studying how people move from rural settings to urban settings, and he coined the idea of, this was a good record of how people were going from one community to another community. Building on that idea, Max Weber thought, if we look at change over time in the 1920s, we can study how community develops, how communities change, and what that really means. So they put to definition Gesellschaft as society, meaning that we work together for our self-interest. And Weber put together the idea of Gemeinschaft, that we are community, that we work for a broader purpose. This is Gesellschaft. This is a mural by Diego Rivera, made in 1933. It is found in Detroit, Michigan. It was commissioned by the Detroit Institute of Art to tell the story of the auto industry in the city of Detroit. And if we look at the image, we see the essence of Gesellschaft. We see people of different races, of different social classes, of people coming together for a common purpose. But each person in there has a different purpose. While we see people building cars and working in a factory, they don't go to work because they love factories. They didn't go to work because they love building cars. They went to work because they had a rational, efficient self-interest. They needed to provide a roof and food for their families. That's Gesellschaft. On the other hand, we get Gemeinschaft. This is Peter Bruegel's painting, 1568, my Dutch just failed me, The Farmer's Wife and the Wedding. You can visit this painting in Vienna if you would like to, and it is the essence of Gemeinschaft. It is a community. It is people who have come together because of shared values. There is nothing to gain. Okay, it's a wedding, there's something to gain. But there's nothing immediate to gain in the sense of why you're there. You're there because you care about the people. You're there because you want to share this moment. You're there not as a rational, efficient interest. You're there because you care about the people around you. Why is this a TED Talk? I wanted to give you a bit of preface into my story of moving from Gesellschaft to hopefully Gemeinschaft. In 1989, I worked at Seattle Repertory Theater. I had a degree in journalism, I was working in public relations, I was making my way in marketing. It was an exciting place to be, celebrities, fast pace, lots of energy, great networking, great events, and we had just won the Tony Award for Outstanding Regional Theater. So technically, I am a Tony Award winner. The events were phenomenal. Once a year, they would have a gala. And the design team, the set builders and the lighting experts would come in, and they would go to a local hotel, and they would turn it into an enchanting event. And in 1989, it was Carnevale di Venezia. And they had bridges and gondolas, they were wearing masks, and they had fire jugglers, and it was really quite extraordinary. And at $500 a plate, it really should be. And they created this spectacular event to raise money for the arts. Pause here. about to be very critical at that moment. On my way into the party, this very elegant event, I had to step over a homeless person. Literally, step over a homeless person to go to this party. I thought, what am I doing? Why does this matter? How is going to a party, how is putting on a play, changing his life? And it struck me in ways that I had not anticipated, because it reached into me and called to some passions that I had put down before. Because in my undergraduate, as I was doing my degree in journalism, I thought, I should be a history teacher. I love history. I love working with people. No, put that down. There's no money in teaching. And I thought, maybe what I drive, maybe what I wear is not as important as what I do. I went to the party, I finished out the year with the theater company, it was a great year, things went well, and through a series of events, I moved to Texas and went back to school to become a teacher. And that moment stuck with me, because I realized that it was my passion, but not just about me, but about community, about leaving my community better than it was when I arrived. And so, what is this about? Why do we talk about Gemeinschaft and Gesellschaft and theaters as we look at this? Because I want for you what I found in understanding community. That the world is bigger than ourselves. And that the world is more fun when we finish together instead of alone. And before I become a series of motivational posters that you put up on the wall, I want to kind of maybe give some pointers as to how we achieve that. So how do we achieve Gemeinschaft? Well, one of the really important parts of it is empathy. And empathy is only found in face-to-face relationships. You cannot develop empathy with someone on a screen. Whether it be a movie, and you think, oh, I love them, I like them so much. You have feelings or you have sympathy, but you don't have empathy. Empathy is a different relationship. The way to achieve that is to put your screens down. And we are very comfortable with screens. And we've all seen videos of doing that. And people walking off of edges of things and walking into things. Because they're so distracted. Because they're not in community. The other issue with that is that social media deceives us. It tells us we have friends on, well, I would say Facebook, but you would say Snapchat. It tells us that we have influencers. It tells us that we have impact on people through social media, but it's not a real community. A Reddit community is just a group of people reading stuff. How is that community? So let me make some suggestions. One would be meet new people. We eat, many of you, eat with the same people three times a day. A group of four or five people, they're your good friends. And they're important to you. And you're important to them because you all tell each other that you're important to each other. Maybe community is a little bigger than that. Branch out and find out. Try volunteering without being told or for cast hours. You're welcome. Find ways to join together. Make habits that are positive. Build traditions with people beyond yourself. And understand that the goal of Gesellschaft is important. But the goal of Gemeinschaft is lasting. So we have come to this point. I've been talking a little bit of rambling. And you're starting to think, well, it's been a long evening. When do we get to go? But I would like to share that I understand that my journey from Gesellschaft to Gemeinschaft has been imperfect, and it's not done yet. But I know that on this path,